So there's my Pearl Export kit in black that I've been jamming on since, I mean, quite a few years now. My dad had a Red Pearl Export kit like my whole life, so Pearl drums have been in my house forever. And when my wife and I behind the camera moved to Nashville, I learned that Pearl was based here in Nashville. So I met with them recently, we got to talking, and I've seen all kinds of cats play the Pearl Decade Maple series. And I'm just gonna open up one box for now and then do more later, but this is gonna be my first look. I did get to play a Pearl Decade because Pearl's based here in Nashville. A lot of the clubs here in town are backlined with Pearl kits, so I've been jamming on a lot of Pearl drums since I've moved to town. We're just going with something small, just so we can take a peek. Can we guess what color it is? You know, we got the black kit, and I wanted to go with something else that I knew would be timeless. So I have the Pearl Decade Maple Series in satin white, and that looks amazing. I actually have never seen it in person. I just knew that I wanted to go with it. Holy shit. Hello, hello. That is hot. Probably can't tell on the camcorder, but it kind of has like almost like a shimmer to it. Hello, Decade Maple. And you don't even have to tune it. It just comes out of the box off the truck, ready to go. But no, this is what these bad boys look like. Once it's all set up, I'll probably like just throw a couple room mics here in the room. Nothing too crazy, but just to give like a very like natural demonstration of what these bad boys sound like. Shout out Pearl, I'm excited to get these bad boys set up here in the room. And then what's cool is that I can keep these Pearl drums as sort of my road and gigging drums. And I can just pummel these guys into the ground, and these are gonna be my new babies that I keep here at home in the studio to preciously take care of. And then maybe someday, you know, when I'm playing in Kiss like Eric Singer, then, you know, for now, this will be good. So I just got done with phase one of unboxing this Decade Maple kit here. There's the 12-inch rack tom I opened up before. I kind of was going for the two up, two down concept. So we got 12 and 13 there for my rack toms. And then I got this 16-inch floor and the 18-inch floor. But the big kahuna back here is a 24-inch kick drum, currently headless, but we'll fix that soon. A few of the drums came in one big old box, so heads and rims and such I need to, you know, get intact. More often than not, my whole life I've been playing 22-inch kicks, so I'm super excited to mess with and be able to record and really get to know in person what it's like playing a bass drum this big. So phase two is gonna be starting to put some heads, and yeah, super excited to get this kit together and start making some sounds. So right now, I just started to put together the bass drum here, and surprise, surprise, when I opened up the bass drum box, there was a mount for the tom in there, along with the additional hardware for the bass drum. And I started off with the toms, and the 12-inch tom was sort of bought separately, and that came with the mount already on the tom. And then the 13-inch tom, 16-inch floor tom, and then the kick again, those sort of come as a set, and you could buy the three-piece. And then the great thing about the Decade Maple series is I think they have toms like from 8 to 18 basically, and you know, your typical sizes, so that's awesome. There's always room to expand. But anyway, I got this guy in a snare stand right now, but once we start to get some sounds, I'm definitely gonna pop this guy on a mount instead.
All right, so we got the two up, we got the two down, we got the 24-inch kick, Pearl Decade Maple series, satin white. I'm touching these and playing a little bit at the moment. So once the snare comes in the next few days or so, we're gonna get the room mics in here, we're gonna do a proper jam. The only non-Decade Maple piece I decided to go for with my new drum set is this Pearl Sensitone snare. I am pretty excited. This is definitely, probably like the highest end drum I've ever owned. So I'm excited to see it in person. Oh, so I couldn't off the top of my head actually. Oh my god! Oh, that just looks unreal. I'm not even, I feel like it feels like I'm trying to sell it or something, but it just, I mean, this is just the most gorgeous drum I've ever owned. Hold on. So as far as Sensitone snare drums go, let's see, we have the beaded steel, we have the beaded brass, we have the seamless aluminum. What I decided to go with here was the beaded brass snare drum. And man, I watched a bunch of different videos comparing the different Sensitone snare drums, and you know, sound-wise, I'm just so excited to crank this guy up, but I mean, this just looks just unreal how gorgeous this snare drum looks. So, I mean, oh, shout out them. Nice Remo Ambassador right on top, right out of the box. Okay, so I'm gonna go plop this snare drum on the drum kit. I'm gonna start getting comfortable, and then let's hear how this drum set sounds in context. Thank you. a very YouTube-y ending to a video. I am sorry about that. So, thanks for watching the whole thing. This is definitely the longest video I've ever uploaded. These Pearl Decade Maple drums deserved a very proper, extended, detailed video to show off. I am loving them. I've been playing them more and more and more. And yeah, so a few things. One, I did a podcast somewhat recently called The Pocket. It's a podcast for drummers and entrepreneurs and creatives and just generally anybody that likes podcasts. I was a guest. I'm gonna link that below, and if you wanted to go listen to that podcast, it'd be pretty cool. I think Justin would appreciate it, and I'd love your perspective and feedback. Number two, you guys know I've been collaborating and working with Sweetwater. They helped me put together the studio. My move to Nashville would not have been so smooth if it wasn't for Sweetwater. So, one thing I want to throw out there, I do have an affiliate link. These Pearl Decade Maple drums and everything and anything you could possibly ever need as a musician is basically on Sweetwater. If you were to buy something going through my affiliate link, that would bring a small little piece of that back to me. So if you watch my YouTube channel, or you have been watching my YouTube channel for years, or this is the first video and you want to contribute without having to do anything other than just doing the thing you wanted to do anyway, the Sweetwater affiliate link is the way to do it. And I also wanted to just say, I have an email address now called hello@RickyFicarelli@gmail.com. And especially if you've gone out of your way to watch this whole video, I'd love to hear from you. I want to try to be more engaging and get better at communicating and talking with people that are, as of right now, just sort of internet figments of my imagination. But I want to become actual acquaintances, at least electronically. Thanks for watching this video. Shout out Pearl Drums. Love my beautiful Empress Cymbals I've been rocking all year. I only used a Crash and a Ride for this video just to kind of keep it simple. Love these head sticks. Been a real game changer in just, you know, playing out a lot and playing in the studio a lot and really only needing one or two pairs of sticks at a time because they don't break unless I'm just being a complete obnoxious animal. So, that should do it. Yeah, if you have a drum cover request, you can email the hello@RickyFicarelli@gmail.com. That'd be a cool way to do that. So I'll have another more drum cover type video soon. And until then, take care.